Hey everybody, welcome to First 15 Live. Chris Pettit here. I am posting our verse and pinning it to the top. Thanks for joining me and my friend Sonny and all those who are part of making this happen and sharing and commenting. Our goal here at First 15 Live is real simple. We want to make spending time with God every day go viral. That's it. We want all believers everywhere to spend time with God every day. 15 minutes. You can spend 15 minutes with God. Make it a priority. So thanks for jumping on this morning. I've posted a link to 21 Days of Prayer at Church of the Highlands, which will start at 9 o'clock this morning. So you can watch that and be a part of that. And I got a good one for you this morning. I'm going to tell you a story about somebody whose life is not terrible, but it seems terrible to them. And I think we're going to see a really good lesson in that. So let me dive right in here and say hello. Good morning, Sonny. Glad to have you, buddy. Nika, glad to have you. Michelle, glad to have you. Glennie, glad to have you. Leela, thanks for being on. Nika, long time no see, so glad to have you here this morning. Jason, hey, don't forget, next Saturday, it's on. Next Saturday. Trin, good morning. Angie, good morning. Mom, good morning. You're actually inside the house here. Kevin, did I get anybody else? There we go. Oh, praying for you, Jason. That's terrible. And anybody else, if you got prayer requests, drop them on. Corey, glad to have you. Thank you, Sonny, and the four others who shared. If you haven't shared yet, please do so. That's important. Let's people know what we got going on. And that's what it's all about, making it go viral. So your shares are actually what's most important to me on here. So, Marshall, thanks for being on here. We will pray for your uncle in the ICU. Man, pray for God to do something amazing. Well, Nika, you can comment. Comment if you watch them later, comment. So if you're watching this later, comment, because it lets me know who's watching, and I love to kind of engage in that. So so anytime you're watching later, comment. So thank you, Nika. That gave me a good way to segue into that. Jessica Riddle is having surgery. When's she having surgery? I'll see her tomorrow, maybe today. I don't know if she'll be at y'all's party. But all right, let me dive right into this. All right, so here's the verse. Esther chapter 5, verse 13. This is Haman talking, and Haman is the one who had the plot to kill all the Jews here in the book of Esther, right? Like, that was his plan. He wanted to murder all the Jews, and so Mordecai wasn't bowing down to him. But now here's the thing about Haman. His life is great. He's like the second most rich, most powerful person in the whole, possibly, world. I mean, he's just got this amazing situation in his life, but here's what he says. Then he added, but this is all worth nothing as long as I see Mordecai the Jew just sitting there at the palace gate. So he had this one person in his life, Mordecai, who actually was right in not bowing down to him, but only bowing down to God. But Haman didn't see it that way. And so Haman was so frustrated that no matter how awesome his life was, no matter how everything else was going well, no matter what, any of those things, thank you, Glennie, and the six others who've shared. Vanessa, glad to have you on here. She's having surgery right now on her appendix. Wow. Definitely praying for her. That's crazy. Was it like a sudden thing? Sorry, that ADD kicked in. So no matter how great his life was, he had this one thing, this one deal that ruined everything for him. And how many times do we do that? Come on, it's a perspective issue. Your life will be going great. Everything can be fine. But let one person say something funny to you. Let your husband say something crazy to you. Let your wife say something crazy to you. And it's like the whole world, you know, one person doesn't like you. It doesn't matter how many people have loved you, how many people believe in you. But that one person doesn't like you, and it's like end of the world for you. How about this? You may have a friend that has been by your side for years, and then one thing happens, and all you can think about is how terrible that person is. And they've been good to you for years, but the whole relationship goes down the drain over one something stupid. Does that make sense? We do that. That's the Haman perspective. The Haman perspective is, my life may be perfect in every area, but because one thing's off, one thing doesn't work right, I cannot focus, I can't be I can't pay attention. I can't be happy because this one thing isn't right. Doesn't matter that everything else is right. This one thing's not right, and that's the only thing I can focus on. So how do you fix the Haman perspective? Well, you lift your eyes up. You realize that everything else is good, and you put that one thing to the side, and you say, God, you take care of that. I'm going to enjoy. I'm going to declare. I'm going to talk about all the things that are good in my life. I'm going to magnify the good things. I'm going to think about, the Bible says, whatever's good and pleasant, whatever's holy, think on these things, right? And so you need to be thinking on the things in your life that are good. Pay attention to those things and give the Lord the things that maybe aren't as good. It's a perspective issue. So what areas of your life today are got you so distracted from all the good God's doing in your life? Is it your job? Is it something at your job? Is it a person at your job? Is it Michelle Hamby, glad to have you on here. What is it that's got you so distracted? Can I tell you, some of you won't go to church because of one little small thing. And you can't focus, right? You can't, I can't go, I can't do this, I can't be that, because we got one small thing, one something somebody said to you, one fear you have, and you're so focused on that one thing, you miss all the good that God wants to do in your life if you be a part of a church family. Does that make sense? And we have all these, like, God wants to work in your marriage, but he can't because you're holding back because of one little thing, and that's all you can focus on. That's the Haman mindset. God's mindset is, look at what God is doing good, and let me focus on that. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. All right, so I want to challenge you to focus, look in your life, and say, what thing is distracting you from all the good that God's doing in you? All the things you have. Let's not be like Haman, whose life was so amazing, but in his mind it was so awful because of one guy who wouldn't bow down to him. Not to mention, everybody else in the whole country was bowing down to him, but one guy wouldn't, and that's all he could pay attention to. So, hey, let me pray for you. I'll pray for I'll pray for you, Jason, for healing. I'll pray for Jessica for sure right now. I'll pray for your uncle, Marshall. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for healing and Lord, just a radical turnaround in Marshall's uncle. But Lord, if it's your will to take him home, God, I pray you encourage the family, you strengthen the family, and let your light be seen in that situation, God. Or give them joy for mourning in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for Jason for absolute healing right now. Lord, that even as we pray, God, that fever would break, God, that healing would move in his body, Father. He'd feel it even right now, Holy Spirit. He'd feel, or just better in Jesus' name. Lord, we pray for Jessica, God, that you'd be with her. God, that you would touch her. God, that you would bring healing right where she's at. Give the doctors wisdom and move in her situation. In Jesus' name. Amen. Hey, listen, if you haven't shared, thank you, Michelle Hamby, for the share and the seven others who shared. Please do so. If you're watching later, comment. It really is important to me to know, who really is watching, because sometimes it'll tell me, you know, we have 800 or 900 views or something on a video, but I want to know who that is. And so let me know who's watching. And if this is doing something for you, encourage me, help me out, because we're trying to make the Word of God and spending time with God go viral every single day. So if you haven't liked our page, please like our page. You can also get our new cover photo. You can download it and make it your cover photo. These are all ways you can help spread the word. Thank you, Jason Hamby, for the share. Thank you, Glennie. I'm glad to do it. Michelle, do a rewatch. It's good. Haman, the Haman mindset. You got to get that out of your head. That everything can be good. One thing could be your focus that's been negative, and we gotta turn that around. So we need to focus on all the good God's doing. Love you guys. Don't forget 9:00. There's a link on here at 9:00. 21 days of prayer at Church of the Highlands starts, and you can be part of that. So love you guys, and I will see you tomorrow morning at 8:30. Bye.